Democrats are firmly convinced that climate change is the most pressing issue on the agenda. This is what all of the Democrats say. If you ask them, what is the existential threat to the United States? They will not say China. They will not say Russia. They will not say Islamic extremism. What they will say is climate change to a person. And what they suggest is that America radically restructure our economy in a Green New Deal. Yay! We're going to abolish the driving of private cars. We are going to cut our military in half. We're going to radically restructure all of the tax brackets. Weird how all of their solutions to climate change sound exactly like their ideal fiscal proposals just in a vacuum. Weird how those things line up. Wow. Okay, but there's one problem. It turns out that all of the highfalutin talk about how the United States has not done its share to fight climate change is ignoring the fact that the vast majority of emissions are not coming from the United States on an absolute basis. The vast majority of emissions are coming from China because China has 1 billion people and they're emitting without any regulations upon them, despite the fact that they signed on to the much vaunted Paris Accords. Remember the Paris Accords? Donald Trump pulled out of it and the world was supposed to end. We were all going to die. Well, it turns out we didn't sign the Paris Accords and we lowered emissions more than any industrialized country last year. And China did sign the Paris Accords and they didn't lower emissions at all. Samini Sengupta, writing for the New York Times, China, the world's coal juggernaut, has continued to produce more methane emissions from its coal mines, despite its pledge to curb the planet-warming pollutant, according to new research. In a paper published Tuesday in Nature Communications, researchers concluded that China had failed to meet its own government regulations requiring coal mines to rapidly reduce methane emissions, at least in the 5 years after 2010, when the regulations were passed. Not only were the reductions not made, but Chinese methane emissions actually increased by 1.2 million tons per year during the five-year period. What? A communist dictatorship pledging to help the environment in order to shame Western countries into doing the same and then cheating? You mean communists lie? You mean communist dictatorships that have giant gulags don't care if they pollute at the expense of people other places in the world? That's crazy. That's but they're good because they're on the left. I mean, if we, Thomas Friedman, I was assured by Thomas Friedman that if we had just run America as a one-party autocracy, that would have been even better than a one-party democracy. Because if the one-party autocracy is run by the geniuses like the people in China, the world would be better off. Obviously, the solution to this is we have to tax the 1%. The solution to the Chinese government just radically increasing their methane emissions, we have to tax the 1% in this country. That is the only way. Not only that, we should probably have a wealth tax. Not only that, we should probably boycott Israel. Like, we should, you know what? We should just do a bunch of things that have nothing to do with methane emissions, but we will pretend that they have everything to do with methane emissions while the other people who signed on to the Paris Accords and lied about what they were going to do continue to pollute. Clearly, that's the solution. It's our fault. Of course. I mean, come on. We're America. It's obviously our fault. It's just amazing that this continues to be portrayed as some sort of moderation. Just incredible stuff from the Democratic Party.